to in session.
I move accept Article 11 as presented.
I haven't even read it.
I know, but I have.
In the event that Article 3 is defeated, to see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $135,000.00 to be added to the roof expendable trust previously established in 31811 under the provision of RSA 35-1 for the purpose of repairing, replacing, and maintaining roofs on the school buildings, this warrant article to be void and have no effect if Article 3 is approved by the voters. Mm-hmm. I second that motion.
What's the balance in there now?
It says $135,000.
Is the balance?
Yes.
Okay, so you got 440, you got 135. You got a total of $575,000 to pay for the roof if you have to. Thank you.
Hey, right, call the vote.
Without this, or with this?
No, without it.
Without it.
Without it.
Without
okay.
It.
Call the vote.
Lawrence Tilley, yes.
Mark Dekoff, yes.
Steve Miller, no.
Barbara Howard, no.
Lauren Kai, yes.
Three yeses, two so no's.
Passes.
Article 12. In the event that Article 3 is defeated, to see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $44,000.00 to be added to the Windows Replacement Fund previously established in 3805 under the provision of RSA 35-1 for the purpose of replacing the windows at the Alton Central School. This warrant article to be void and have no effect if Article 3 is approved by the voters.
Move Article 12 as presented.
Second. Discussion?
That'll give a total of about $75,000 in that, which could be used for windows other than in the renovated target zone.
It's 44. Yes.
Okay, if I add up what's been approved and what's in the three articles, there's $785,000. If this one is not approved, which is enough to take care of everything.
All right, call the vote.
Keep in mind we can't, the 135 can only be used for roofs and the windows can only be used for windows.
Yes, but the $440,000 can be used for either.
Correct. Yes. Which is why we designed it for that.
Yep.
In case the roof collapses again, which we would like to get the rafters done, but we're going to wait.
If you thought that it would, if you thought that was imminent, you would have done it this year.
Correct.
So it's not imminent. Imminent.
Imminent.
Yeah, aluminum. Imminent. So it obviously is not imminent, you know, to as an emergency situation for the board.
A few years ago, it was just a couple years ago that you had somebody come in that did the review and they gave a waiver for how long? When does that expire?
It's not a waiver. Or the engineer said that he believed that with shoveling that we could maintain that roof. He did his decision to say that the roof was acceptable with the shoveling was that he understood that we were going to be rebuilding in 2 to 3 years. The engineer makes recommendations but does not have the authority unless he believes it is imminent. He does not have the authority to do anything else. It is the building inspector and the fire department that would make any other decision.
How many years?
And he would work with them.
And it's been about 2 years on that, right?
It was the October 2009.
So what he said was as long as it was shoveled, this should not be an issue, correct?
But it was his understanding that we were renovating in 2 to 3 years.
And when? Who told him we were renovating and when?
Well,
that was a discussion when he came. Okay. Because he was the engineer who had come in when we had the roof rafter issue before. So we asked him to come back and look at that roof, all of the rest of the roofs, which because of the mineral fibers that we had, he actually only looked in 4 sections of the building, and he pulled down 4 sections to look at, and out of the 4 sections, there were 2 sections that had some cracks. So that was where he looked at other sections for other reasons. He looked at the kinds of trusses that we have. Unfortunately, we have the trusses that match those that were in the, well, I'll leave the school name out, but another school building that had some serious structural problems, and so he did say that we need to address those issues as well.
How much to put the Band-Aid on the two sections?
The Band-Aid?
How much to fix the two sections? Until somebody's...
That was just two trusses that he was able to, I mean, two...
Sections?
No. All he looked at when he took it down, he literally just took down a section like this.
Yeah.
And looked out to see that. How much to fix those two? You can't do that. You have to take down the whole thing. It's a rafter.
Okay.
It would be like fixing two by fours or two by eights that are in your house.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, half of what he looked at had some problems.
Okay, how much to fix it?
I have no idea.
So, how do you know how much to put in the fund?
I'm going by what we had last time.
The square footage.
And the square footage.
So you may have enough money in the fund to do it then. You don't know. That's what I'm saying. You don't know.
That is correct. And the issue is that if we're going to build a three-story addition, or tear down and build up, it makes no sense to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Because we also need a roof on that same section.
We're on windows, we're not on roofs.
I was going to say, we're on windows.
So let's go back and take the vote on the Article 12 on the windows.
Can I ask, what are you expecting to spend $71,000 on windows, on this next phase of window replacement?
We have 31.1 right now.
Linda, you the school board rep here?
Yes.
You
might want to sit up there.
Mm-hmm.
I think they want you.
Sorry. It's your choice. Linda, it's your choice.
Linda Goosens, come on down.
Hey, you missed the worst of it. Don't worry about it.
Hey,
tell her she's okay.
We're not going back to anything.
I stayed home sick today, so you're lucky to be here.
Oh,
do you have a note?
I wish I did.
So are we taking the vote? You get your answer?
Well, I don't see. I don't know if they're going to put, if the next phase is $31,000 or $77,000 or $44,000.
Yeah, I think, you know, the same concern. You know, we don't want to see this just growing with the intention of rolling it into, you know, a larger project.
We indicated that they will be done in 2013.
How much?
Do you know how much?
How much?
Well, the sections that we're planning on doing, we're going to put $44,000 in this year and an additional $44,000 in, and that will do those windows except for that middle school section.
We have a bid. Do you have a cost to do that? Is there, has somebody submitted a bid? Or a cost?
There's 31,000.
We did an estimate based on the square footage.
And how much is the estimate?
Well, the total air plus an additional $88,000.
So 31,000 plus?
That answers a question.
88, 112.
That's for all windows except for the renovation target zone.
The ones that we need to do, which will include, because right at the moment we feel that we can handle what's in the ERC. They're not great, but we can leave them. But it will take care of the rest of the middle school wing and the sixth grade wing. And I think the some sections in that ERC.
Was the plan to wait until all of it can be done at one time, or, you know, start?
It saves some of the saves disruption of the school to do construction all at once. There is obviously disruption to the educational process when you do piecemeal. Every time you go in and do some renovation.
At this
renovation.
Point, you'd have to wait until better weather anyway, right?
Oh,
no.
Well, I was just meaning like this summer, for
the
example.
The process is, we're talking 2013 anyway.
Oh.
But yes, every time you do a renovation, you do disruption to the school and the educational process. And so doing it all at once means you kind of do the disruption, you're done. If you do it this year, this year, this year, this year, it disrupts differently.
Yeah.
All right, take the vote.
Lauren Carr, yes.
Mark Dekoff, yes.
Lawrence Tilley, yes.
Steve Miller, yes.
Barbara Howard, yes.
Linda Goosens, yes.
Linda, are you the school board rep supposed to be here today? Or you don't know? Okay.
I wasn't told I was supposed to be here today.
Did you vote?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, Article 13. In the event that Article 3 is defeated, to see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $30,000 and no cents to be added to the bathroom refurbishment fund previously established in 3805 under provision of RSA 35-1 for the purpose of refurbishing the bathrooms at the Alton Central School. This warrant article to be void and have no effect if Article 3 is approved by the voters.
Motion to accept Article 13 as presented.
Second.
How much is in there now?
I read the wrong line. I need a ruler. The window replacement had $1,800 on it. I looked at the one below it. I apologize. Right now, in the bathroom refurbishment line, there is $31,000 in it.
There's $31,000 in there?
Correct.
How long has it been in there for?
We spent... went in there in 05.
Then your article... This article's wrong, then. Article 3 is wrong.
Article 3 says 1839.23 from bathroom refurbishment.
And then 31,000 from window replacement.
In a typo.
So they were reversed.
Okay.
Okay. So the vote's not good.
Still comes to the total dollar amount. I'm sorry.
Okay,
I know
so we need to switch. So it's a bathroom in the window?
Yeah. Thank you for catching that.
So how long has the $31,000 been in there?
It went in there. It was established in 2005. We have withdrawn from it last year in the 2010-2011 school year to replace the windows, to replace the bathroom in the middle school wing. $69,302 was taken out. $69,302 was taken out.
And there's
$1,800 left.
Is $1,800 in there now?
No, the bathroom, there's $31,000.
Oh, 31.
Sorry, right. I'm sorry, confused. We're going.
Okay, so I have a question. There's 31.
Correct.
31's been going in there for since 2005?
No. It was established in 2005.
At how much?
My spreadsheet doesn't go that far back.
Okay. How far does it back to go?
It goes to, 2000. The balance at the end of 2008, 2009 was at $69,302.
And you spent $38,000 so far?
$69,302.
And you spent $69,000?
Yep. And we added $30,000 last year into it. So now we're at $31,000.
Okay, if we put money into it this year, will it be expended this year? Will it be expended next year?
2 years is the plan.
How much will you need in 2 years?
We would, if we did not do something, it would be only those in the ERC.
Just how much in
probably
money?
Somewhere between $70,000 and $80,000. And the issue there is that we don't have any drains.
Right.
In that back bathroom, so we need to address that. So that would probably increase the cost. The problem there is that we need to figure out the septic system because that was planned for renovations as well. So I won't guarantee that we would do that.
And you would expend the money not next year, in 2 years for sure if there's no the bond doesn't go through?
Well. That's what I just said, Steve. Part of the issue is that the septic that's out there is reaching the end of its time because it was put out there a little over about 20 years ago. We were not going to just replace, to redo that because we needed to move it for the way that we were going to redo the fields. And then we would need to hitch up drains from that bathroom. We need drains in the floor. So we would then hitch that up to the new septic.
Okay.
So it's kind of a step by step by step. But that's the plan. We will not redo the bathrooms that are in the biggest need again because it's in that oldest part of the building.
Okay. Could you have spent the $31,000 and fixed up bathrooms?
Or, no. Fix the leach, the drainage?
No.
Oh, okay.
Because we still don't know where we're going to put the drain. But we do recognize that as an issue.
Okay.
I mean, right now, if the bathroom overflows and they have to clean it. I'm not.
Hi, we're ready to call the vote?
But
Lauren,
that would be the bathroom that we would do.
Lauren Kai, yes.
Barbara Howard, yes.
Steve Miller, yes.
Mark Decott, yes.
Lawrence Tilley, yes.
Nicholson, yes.
Article 14, in the event that Article 3 is defeated, to see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $30,000 and no cents to be added to the Capital Reserve Fund previously established in March 1998 under the provision of RSA 35-1 for the purpose of installing a fire suppression system. This article to be void and have no effect if Article 3 is approved by the voters. This one's just basically going to keep building up until the addition.
Yes.
That doesn't make sense. Well, no, it doesn't make sense to build up a fire suppression until a bond is finally passed. Until a bond is finally passed. Either we're going to pay for a fire suppression system in the school or we're not.
Well, we already have put some in.
I know it.
We did.
Mm-hmm.
But if you wind up redoing those roofs, would you put more in?
Yes.
How much is in there now?
$239,011.
What's the bid for?
What did it cost to put in the one and the other?
Let me find out what the bid is.
We haven't gone out to bid.
Okay, how much is it going to cost?
I don't know.
So how'd you come up with $30,000?
Because we're going to put money aside to be able to have the cost be less against the tax rate when we do the full suppression system.
Okay, so how do you know how much to ask for? Is it how much pain the voters
will
entail?
We were given an estimate around $750,000 to $800,000. But again, we've done a portion of that when we put in the pipes, plumbing part. So part of that money was already taken out of the original.
How much is that taken out?
$55,347.
Okay, so it's three quarters of a million dollars. Hmm. And there is, when you put in the fire suspension system, at $30,000 a year, This is a forever deal, correct?
The rest will be part of the bond.
What bond? What, for the renovation?
Yes.
If the bond was to pass.
Correct.
Right, but here we're just using this as a petty cash fund to work against the big bond issue.
Are we required to have more fire extinguishers because we don't have the fire suppression?
No.
No? Interesting.
The fire suppression is required at a particular point when the renovation reaches a
right.
certain percentage.
How much was it to fix the one in the high school? How much was it to fix the one in the high school?
Well, whatever they got in there.
200.
You had to
close to 180, 200.
Much?
Between 180 and 200.
To fix
that's it. To flush it.
They have
and
to flush
to
it.
Put the sprinkler heads on. It's already in there.
Gosh, this seems awful high. $750,000.
Right now you got $239,000 in there. So
that includes a generator.
Yeah, well, you need $520,000 divided by $30,000 a year. It's going to be 10 years before you can do it. That's crazy.
Hey.
The rest would be bonded at the time of the renovation.
Uh-huh.
And if the renovation, you know, to get to your point, if the renovation is, you know, doesn't happen in the next 3-4 years and you're having to do roof work and such,
we would take from this account to do what we did before and get at least the plumbing parts in there. And at some point, if we do enough of this kind of work, we'll have enough of it in that it would make sense to have the system put in.
Take the vote. Mark Decoff, yes.
Lawrence Tilly, yes.
Steve Miller, no.
Linda Goosens, yes.
Lauren Kai, yes.
So we're, okay, if you fix the roof, you're going to put in more of the fire suppression. If you don't fix the roof, then it's going to be, fall under the bond. If the school passes.
It will reduce the cost of the bond the same way you saw the rest of these articles reducing the cost, the rest of these trusts reducing the cost.
So if you fix the roof and you put in more, is that going to have to be torn out?
No.
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 Barbara Howard, yes. So.
Five yes, one no. Article 15, to see if the school vote to establish a contingency fund under the provision of RSA 198-4-B to meet the cost of unanticipated utility expenses that may arise.
I thought we did this.
Yeah.
I thought you did it. Do you know what the vote was?
Sorry.
What was the final vote?
That one was six yes, one no. Okay, Article 16. In the event that Article 3 is defeated, to see if the school district will vote to create an expendable trust fund under the provision of RSA 198-20-C, known as the Parking Lot Paving Expendable Trust, for the purpose of repairing, replacing, and maintaining parking lots on the school properties. Furthermore, to raise and appropriate the sum of $10,000, no cents towards the purpose, and to name the school board as agents to expend from this fund. The warrant article to be void and have no effect if Article 3 is approved by the voters.
The intent is to wait to do this because of the amount of work that would be done in the parking lot during a renovation. However, we have planned to redo this in any event at the end of 2014.
So that we don't have a trust now?
No. This is new.
Okay.
This would put $30,000 aside.
Ten.
Well, total, 30 over the, by 2014.
Lauren Kai, yes.
We haven't got a motion.
Oh, I move it then.
Second.
Getting late here.
Take the vote.
Lawrence Tilly, yes.
Mark, so we're not having any discussion.
You want discussion? Okay.
No.
Mark Decoff, yes.
Steve Miller, no.
Barbara Howard, no.
Linda Goosens, yes.
Passed.
No. Let me just write down my votes.
And you can go home? Yeah. Okay. Now, this one you added, because I don't have this one in my last one, because I have Article 17 written down as passed, which was the 20,000, so you added an article since the last time we met.
I think it went down from 20 to 15.
We changed it.
No, I don't have that article. I have Article 17 as the Alton Professional Development Fund.
We did have an article for a trust on the facilities truck, but the board decided to just have it as a purchase truck.
But the last time we talked, where I wrote all my articles, this article was not in there. So this is a brand new article that's just coming in front of us.
And I don't have my last sheet with me either.
Did you almost fall? I thought he almost fell out of the chair.
How about that?
Okay, no, that's tonight. Let me just look through it.
This is Article 17, and that's Article 17.
Yeah, huh. 60.
When did you vote on that article? When the school board okayed that article?
Monday night, wasn't it?
No, it was before that.
It was before then.
It's top 150.
You talked about it because you said it was high mileage.
I'm just looking through all of them.
Yes, we had a long discussion about it.
He talked about this because he said that it was high miles.
Yeah.
That's when he was here.
Right.
And we were talking on his budget.
Yeah, we were talking the maintenance budget at that time.
Yeah, it doesn't have it in it.
Yeah.
It wasn't in the budget, is it?
Well,
No, but when he was talking about the maintenance on the vehicle, and we were asking about the miles.
That was just.
Can we pull it out? Is that what it was?
Okay. So, Article 17 now is to see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $15,000 and no cents to replace the current facilities truck with a used truck with a plow.
Without a plow.
Without a plow, sorry.
Taking the old plow off the other one.
Why do we need a truck today and we didn't need one for the past 30 years?
Because it's dying now. It's got how many miles?
How many miles?
It's got not a heck of a lot of miles,
it's
but
just rotten.
Yes, it's deteriorating and
What do you need it for?
Plowing around the area of the
but
school.
But you're taking off the plow.
Because we're getting using the other plow.
Okay.
Because we're reusing.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So it's not that you're not going to have it as a plow
truck. Why
can't
you use a four-wheel utility vehicle for that?
A four-wheel utility vehicle. We don't have a four-wheel utility
vehicle. No, I mean instead of $20,000.
Well, we do also transport skis to Gunstock. We do the daily run between the Alton Central School and the SAU office, as well as the Prospect Mountain High School.
Why can't the skis go on the bus with the kids?
It's not allowed. It's a safety issue.
They don't have an underneath.
We do not have capacity for it.
What is this, for $20,000?
$15,000.
So you're going to buy a used vehicle?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I motion we accept the article as I read it.
Second.
You know.
And there are parent chaperones on the ski trips because when my kids
went. I'm not.
So there's no reason why you couldn't coordinate for parents to help transport. We shouldn't be buying a truck just to transport skis.
You asked what we use it for.
Yeah, I know.
And I did
the chaperones may not have vehicles that could transport the skis, especially enough for the children. You know, if they've got small cars. You know, I can get one pair of skis in my Volvo.
I know, for you, buddy. I don't go through this town without getting stuck behind a minivan at least every day. So.
But they may not be chaperoning.
That's only the use of the truck, though, for those 4 days of the year. I mean, there's a lot of other uses for it throughout the year.
It is used for that.
Didn't by any chance see how much a new truck from the state bid would be.
A new truck or a used truck?
No, from the state bid. We can go on with the state bid.
I believe it was the board's pleasure not to buy new. It was not worth buying something new, even.
But if it's only a couple thousand more dollars for a new one from the state bid, it would be worth looking at it. I mean, I don't know where that is, but I had that. It's unbelievable how much cheaper they get them than what you can buy them.
That's fine.
And I agree with the $15,000, but
I thought we were buying one from the state. That's what I thought we were going to get used from the state.
Looking at the surplus.
Yeah.
But they're not new. They're
right.
Used.
But I mean, if you can get them the same price new, that's new's
always
better.
Or a few thousand dollars more.
You'd probably save on the maintenance.
Yeah.
That's true.
I'll say it again. Motion to accept is read.
Second.
Discussion?
So, Lauren, how would you word that then? Could you word it for either?
A new or used truck without plow.
Okay. And so we have to talk to Russ?
No matter what, you're only going to be able to spend $15,000, so.
But should we talk to Russ and see if it's like 18 then, you mean? If it's 18, would you think that would be better to get a new one at 18 than a used one at 15?
All we have to do is take out the word used.
Well, new or used, because we're going to.
No, just
doesn't matter. Just take
out
the word
just
used.
Buy a truck.
Yeah, just take out to buy a facilities truck
for $15,000
with a truck.
Yeah, but if you're saying a new one's like a couple thousand more,
yeah, I don't know. You have to go on. They have a list, a whole list of all.
I know. So, but we got to find a price. Then, would you recommend a new one over a used one? Then,
if it was a $2,000 more, yes.
Yes. How do you? Is Russ here?
No.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's going next. He said to hurry up. He's going next.
Can we ask him?
Yeah, he's got some stuff for.
I had the thing somewhere, but
yeah. I'll go ask.
Well, you people can change this before the public hearing.
Right. Absolutely.
It was
right.
It's on this.
I'll agree with the $15,000.
Reviews for the town and the school.
What if the new truck's 17? Wow.
Then I'll consider that the night we have the public hearing. So
I'll
vote for $15,000 at this time. Yes.
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 I'm sure Linda says yes, so.
No, no.
Linda?
We can't do that.
Okay. I'll go get.
Yeah.
I'm all for a used one, but I mean for.
If we're not letting you write your votes down and leave, we're not going to vote her proxy either.
Oh, I'd let him write his votes down and leave.
Thanks.
For the record, Linda Goosen said yes.
raising that low.
Oh, okay. Well, you can look.
We can contact. I'll contact the state.
Look it up.
Find out their surplus.
So Article 18 was 17, and that was voted 4 no, 3 yeses.
I just, and I'm not going to draw this out. I just want to ask the question to the school board member. This is probably the most important budget committee hearing because of the $18 million proposed bond issue in the last 10 years. Why wasn't school board member representative here to defend the position? And thank you for coming, Linda. I really mean that, okay? And I'm sorry, I know you're not feeling well to bring it down, you know, up front. But why?
I know.
Because what we are seeing is that there is no support from the school board for the article. And if that's the assumption, right, then, you know, I just want it on the record, that's all.
I don't know. Last I heard, everyone was coming, so that's why I didn't feel the need to be here, but.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Article 22. To see if the district will vote to raise and appropriate to sum of $45,000.
Did you get Linda's vote on the truck?
Yes.
Yeah, it was six. Six yeses. Okay. Article 22, to see if the district will vote to raise and appropriate to sum of $45,000 and no cents to purchase and install an internet protocol telephone system for the Alton Central School.
Did you get an estimate on
those? Okay. Wait, are we not doing
Did we skip the PD?
That one already passed.
Already.
Oh.
That one we did last time we were here.
And the final vote was this one?
On the professional development?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You said it was 4 no, 3 yes.
That's what I thought. Okay. The telephone, we are awaiting a final wording of this. The reason being that once we get that wording, this system, and I do have copies. Yeah.
Is this system going to have the same problem in the high school? It couldn't work.
No. This is. Theirs is voice over internet.
Okay.
Ours is an internet protocol that is different.
Okay.
Freehand.
But the reason that we're waiting for the language is that the attorney is trying to write it so that we get the correct wording for applying 2 years in a way that the voters understand what's happening. We are receiving E-rate funding. I think Pam McLeod explained a little bit about E-rate funding. E-rate gives us money's back, it's a reimbursement, because we are a rural school district, a small rural school district, and they want to make sure that small rural school districts get internet access. So we are reimbursed a certain amount for our internet connections and our telephone systems and the ability to connect, have interconnectivity. And so we have received about $20,000 already. We will get a second payment this year. And then next year, we will receive an additional amount of money. Now, the issue, as you know, school districts are not allowed to carry over money, unlike towns. So what we are trying to do is to write the article so that we can carry that money, the revenue, over. And it's either, do we establish a capital reserve or ask to have this be as a surplus? But in the end, the way this can work is the E-rate reimbursements will fully pay for the phone system. And then if you look at, I think it's the third page, the annual costs of this phone system will be reduced. It's about right in the middle of the page, halfway down, where it says the total costs. You'll see the total costs for the current costs at $31,395, and the estimated new cost of the system, annual costs, will be anywhere between $18,567 and $21,567, for an estimated savings per year of somewhere between $9,828 and $12,828. So E-rate will give us, at, through reimbursements over 2 years, the full cost of the system, and then we will save that amount each year. So the article, as it's written, doesn't allow us right now to deal with the carryover. So Barbara's writing the article, and that's the reason that she's writing it, so that we can put the 2 years together and pay for it in 1 year, which would be next year.
So we should table it.
You need to table it. And, right. And I thought she was going to have it, but she and I went over. One. It's a tricky one to try and decide. Do you count it as surplus money and have it be, are you in favor of carrying surplus revenues over and using it into the next year and encumbering it at the end of this year and then just paying for it in that? Or do you establish a non-lapsing trust for 1 year? So she's trying to look into what would be the best way to do that.
So the last one we got to do is this possible warrant article?
Well, I'm going to say, given what you did on the others, you probably are going to not have to spend too much time on it. But we had had a request.
What number is that?
That's the extra sheet. We had had a request that was brought to the Buildings and Grounds Committee and then brought to the board, because the individual had said, I realize that you've pulled the gymnasium out, but there are people who would like to have the whole package. So would you be willing to write an article to allow the voters to have an opportunity to vote on that cost? So this is what the article would read.
So the school board presented this?
The board has actually, the board just said, we're not going to take any action on it yet, because we had agreed with the Buildings and Grounds Committee that we were going to take out the gymnasium to lower the cost for the taxpayer. But this was a request, would they consider having this on the ballot? So at the moment, the board has not taken action about whether to put this on the warrant, but I wanted you to see this at this point. It's officially not on the warrant, but just to let you know that the board may, at their meeting on January 9th, decide to put it on. But this is the cost. Again, you do not have the bond cost for it either, because that, you know, it came in.
My only concern on this would be if the gym went back in, it would significantly change the interior work back toward the original, and that will change the $18 million estimate. So you're saying, should three pass at $18 million, do this. But if you do this, you're not going to necessarily have the exact $18 million anymore.
Chip took all of that into consideration, because I sent off numerous questions. But he did the best he could with that whole thing, and this includes geothermal considerations, but not the full geothermal, because he said, you know, you'd have to eat some of it anyway. So he didn't think that would be a huge cost, but he said, you know, you would want to be able to at least consider it. So, but this is just so that you know that that had been a request and the board may consider it.
So that's it with the school.
No.
Can I keep these?
So that's it for the warrant articles.
Yeah.
Okay.
Except a budget.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, that.
So do we want to look at that, right?
Yep.
So trust it's hers. Could like so to have her budget book back intact.
I will take that.
there was some requests from the last meeting, based on the minutes that I read. On the building and grounds, Kathy O'Blanis confirmed that the retirement number might be an error. And that's something I guess you want to get back to us on.
Yeah, I think we did. I think I had
Okay, that's fine.
I probably brought it with me and we didn't get to it. But yes, it was. And I had corrected it.
Okay. Up or down?
Down.
Okay.
Yep.
Next,
you have
Okay. Under new equipment, There was $5,000 for tools. There was a request for a tool inventory because the statement was, we have some small tools and a drill with no battery. Could I have the inventory on the...
We do not have a list completed at this moment in time.
We have asked the new director, however, to do a complete inventory and supply, a tool inventory and supply inventory.
Okay, so we can assume that, at least I can assume that the statement, we have a few small tools, a drill without a battery, means that we either have lost our tool inventory or was stolen, correct? Unless there's a third possibility?
Misplacement in the facility somewhere.
Okay.
Or broken and not replaced.
Has anybody told you they found all the tools?
No.
Well, they don't know how many tools there were to start with, so that's why building the inventory list is a good start.
And he is working on that.
Okay. I'm 0 for 2. School board was to validate the $2,000 for the right to know. You were going to tell us how many hours were that was based on and what the cost was over the last 12 months. That's in the minutes.
I had the list and that was passed out. He wanted hours. We're just discussing how the list was provided to you as to how many right-to-know requests there were over the past few years, but I don't...
If one request took 25 hours, that could explain a lot. You know what I mean? Yeah, that's why we need to know that. Okay? Under the request for the itemization of the list of supplies that you provided us for $82,000, mm-hmm. right? There was huge amounts of money, multiple entries for future purchases under the heading future. Okay? And that's exactly what our concern was, that there was a significant amount of purchases, done for way out in the future, because not only does it help our budgeting process today, we want to know in the future whether something could be double budgeted or not. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you were going to provide, that's in the minutes too, you were going to provide.
Is this for the supplies for buildings and?
Yeah.
The name of the company.
The name of the company is Future Supplies.
Future Supplies.
That's the name of the vendor. That's not a heading that we put under a PO.
But it doesn't say what the supplies were. I mean, what were the supplies?
I gave you the purchase orders.
Okay.
The purchase orders had a detailed list.
We have the POs then.
Yeah.
Three of them constituted. Yeah.
I'll match up the purchase orders myself. Yep. Thank you.
Yep.
Okay.
And you stated, just to continue on that, you stated that you didn't want to see or didn't want to think that we'd be purchasing additional more supplies exactly like we had done. I am very carefully watching any of those lines in buildings and grounds to assure that we are not buying more of that supply, and we have not.
You know what? That's good enough for me. I'm dropping the subject as far as I'm concerned. That's good. On the library and media, you're going to get back on how many books were purchased over the last year, what can we use as an average cost per book?
Oh, I got all of that to you at the last meeting.
Yep, that was handed out.
I handed that all over. It was about $25 per book.
This is all stuff that I'm pretty sure we gave you a big packet on.
I might have misplaced it, but thank you. I'll borrow somebody else's.
Because we voted the library.
Okay. Yeah, I'm done.
Okay, I had that we had asked for the prior year's job description and the new job description for technology.
Oh, yeah. That was provided, and I have it for everybody. I had picked it up looking for mine, and they gave me
everything. We got the nursing numbers for our nursing visits, the visits to the nurse,
mm-hmm.
correct?
Here it is. One, two, three. Bob, is that personnel? Yeah, authorization. Yeah, personnel authorization. Is that? Also, I have here Alton Central School job description, administrative assistant to the technology director. Here.
Thank you.
Okay, and I also have Technology assistant.
Are you making a pile from over there?
I guess so.
There you go.
It wasn't.
Okay, that's it, that's everything that, I picked up.
Yeah, that's the invoices.
The invoices.
Isn't it for the supplies?
Purchase orders.
Yeah.
Future supply MD Stenson and...
Oh, and there was a question we had about the camp.
Oh, I was right on with that. It would be $23,000, which is what I had estimated that night. $500 per student, and then you had specifically asked about fifth grade. So with the number of fifth graders we have times $500 per student, it should be $23,000.
That was Virgil that asked that, right?
Yep.
Did we put that in?
No.
It's
just a side question.
He asked the question.
It was just a question as to whether or not we should be doing one over the other.
And also for the principal, there was a request under the health services for you're going to find out what the liability was for having one nurse versus one nurse, two nurses, two and a half nurses, et cetera.
Didn't you get that information?
I think I handed everything over to you about the nurse.
Yeah, we went over that. I don't think you had a handout, but you went over in detail all of the information.
Well, we did call all of the other districts, and we found out, you know, how they handle the nurse and the assistant.
No, I understand. And then I asked the question, do you know what, is there any liability if you had, you know, one versus two, and you said versus two or two and a half, and you said, I'll check it out.
I'm actually not sure how you would determine the liability. I mean, you're liable.
Ask your attorney.
No, I'm remembering.
I'm
remembering. It's coming back to me. Sorry.
Yeah.
I did contact them, and they stated to me they were going to get back to me in an email.
Oh, I'm sorry.
They were
now I know what you're talking about.
And I'm sorry. They haven't gotten back to me, so I apologize. That's me not following up with them.
That's okay.
I'm sorry. No. Now I do remember what you were asking about, and we had called Primex.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. That's all. I'm surprised.
So what do you want to do?
Well, I have a number of items I'd like to talk about taking action on.
Would you explain why you'd want to take action on those?
Sure. As a member of the Prospect Mountain High School Budget Committee, we took a position, and it was a unanimous position among the budget committee members from Alton and from Bonstead, not including the two school representatives. But it was always unanimous that when it came to dues and fees, that any dues and fees that were for the benefit of the student should remain. Any dues and fees that were for the professional development of the teacher should be paid by the teacher, because that benefits that teacher's career. It's the teacher's choice. Personally, my only exception to that is when the principal would mandate that a individual attend a specific conference. And to mandate to attend means you have to pay the dues for that conference. Therefore, it made sense, you know, unfunded mandate, you know, we'll go, you know, that would be okay. So to be consistent, that's one thing I would like this budget committee to consider, is eliminating dues and fees that are just for the professional development of the individual teachers.
I can speak to that because we don't do that.
That's not in the budget.
No, we only have dues and fees that benefit the school, the students somehow. For example, the principal would join the New Hampshire Association of School Principals, but get a school subscription, which means we get a whole bunch of other things with it. For example, dues and fees if you're looking in music.
That was turned down at the high school because that is for the that's for the principal. For instance, in the business world, the individual pays for his own professional dues and fees. That's what we expect. We're talking about dues and fees where, you know, we have to be accredited, therefore you have to go to this meeting in order to be accredited, okay?
Okay, I'm trying to think of another example at our school where we have music. We have to...
Special ed for dues and fees, the NHASEA.
Yep.
You can make a case, for instance, for every item in dues and fees is for the ultimate benefit of the child. I understand that. That argument could be made. But we have to form a distinction, which are actually professional dues and fees.
I believe we do. I can tell you I've paid for
each individual one is not a lot of money. $50 here, $150 here. Before you know it, though, it adds up to real money. At the end of the year, it ends up to thousands of dollars.
And at the end of the day, if you choose to leave, what's on your resume? All these, you know, participation and all of these things that have been paid for, you take that with you in your resume as your work experience. So,
and I certainly agree if the benefit is to the individual in that, but I'm going to speak to the New Hampshire School Administrators. I receive no personal benefit. I don't get any discount at any conference. I don't get any discount in any part of that. The benefit of my participation really is a district thing in that the information comes back as far as legislation, updates on what's going on statewide, what's going on nationally is provided to me. And what's going on in the retirement system, all of that is provided in two ways. And that includes weekly updates and then monthly updates at the commissioner's meeting. That information I would have to spend hours getting. The other part to that is the association piece of the sharing that superintendents do. I, like the principal, have the access to a listserv. When I have a question about what's going on, and I think that Sydney spoke to this when you asked about the school nurse, I access that listserv of all of the superintendents who are members and simply say, can you tell me what you're doing about this? And I can break it out by region and just hit the Lakes region, or I can break it out by the state. And that information goes through a filtered listserv, so I know I'm not getting spam, I know I'm not getting something that's a crazy question, and that comes back, and I get that information. So I realize that it may be a lot of money, but it provides information to the district. I have no benefit from that. It's technically dues and fees under the superintendent's line.
Actually, you do benefit from that because that's part of doing your job, which by doing your job, you're able to charge what you charge to do your job. Does that make sense?
As an independent contractor.
I'm not an independent contractor. Well, right now, I guess I am again. But that does not, as an independent contractor, I benefit none whatsoever.
But that this could be, district. You're an independent contractor, so that's a tax write-off for you.
This district benefits, I do not. And I will tell you, if you ask me to pay it, I will not.
No, that's okay. It's a choice you have to make.
But the district loses, not me.
At the next meeting, I'll go over, there's a whole litany of dues and fees, and I have to be sure before I can, before we go over each individual one, what I'm sure of. So what I'm going to do is, with your permission, the ones I'm not sure of, I'd like to call Sydney, okay? And get her opinion. And if they're all for the benefit of the kids, I'm fine. There's no problem there. If there's one or two, I just like to discuss them, okay? The other thing is that the, and this is a matter of being consistent because we have to go to the voters. And when the voters ask, you did this for the high school, why didn't you do this for the central school? We have to give them an honest answer. So this is what made us think about it. All the superintendent's office, the 2% raises was turned down at the high school by unanimous vote. And the reason that it was turned down is that the um, there Barnstead is having record foreclosures and short sales. Alton is in the process of having record foreclosures and short sales, and it's purely an economic issue. This has nothing to do whether or not the staff deserves a 2% raise, because I'm sure the majority of them deserve that, or certainly a good part of that. So this was a financial decision. So that is something that's another thing that this board is going to take a hard look at. And I'll open it for discussion, and I'll motion that we reduce the superintendent's line salary for 2% raises from 3%.
It's 2320. You're going to reduce $46,763.
To zero.
And I'll second that.
And that's absolutely to be consistent.
Discussion.
Who would this cover?
This covers your admin for $18,719, and then it's your support staff, SS,
it's
right?
It's 100% of the staff except those covered by the master agreement.
$28,044.
Barnstead did the same thing with their elementary school as well.
They have a negotiated contract with their support staff.
I'm just telling you what they told us.
They have a negotiated contract with their support staff. They did that in an effort to keep their health insurance.
Okay.
At the same rate that it is.
You were there, right? When he said that.
Yeah, he said it's school. Yeah, it's 0% for the next 2 years.
Zero. They zeroed it out.
No change to health insurance.
I don't know about that.
Mm-hmm. Does that mean that if we come forward with a contract from Prospect and from Prospect and ACS, that you're not going to accept anything unless it's a 0%?
Bonstead's, I think, position.
No, I know. I'm saying when and if we come forward with anything for Prospect and for ACS, is your position going to be 0%?
Increase?
Yeah.
For the teaching staff?
Yeah.
I'd like to see a decrease, personally, or a higher contribution to their health benefits.
I would welcome
retirement.
I would welcome an amendment. I would welcome an amendment to that.
To the
motion to zero it out, to zero that line out. But I understand your point of view. If you want to, generate an amendment, I'm open to it.
Well, I'm just wondering if we're going to be doing what we do for Prospect and. I mean, we have two possible contract negotiations coming forward, and I was just wondering if your answer to that was going to be 0%.
It all depends on the whole package.
I personally would like to see the support staff get a decrease in their copay for their insurance. I think 36.1% for what they make is ridiculous. And you have the certain few that are gaining, and these poor people are just working away, and they're on a merit-based. So there's no guarantee they're even going to get a dime, and they work really hard.
Well, no, they're not going to, because we're going to take the merit away.
30 hours a week with all the problem children. So.
But they're not going to get a merit raise because we're taking it away.
Yeah. Well, it's unfortunate that we have to do that to them in order to make cuts in administration.
All right, do you want to take the vote?
Lori Cannon.
Is there a motion? Who seconded the motion?
Who?
I did.
Yeah, Steve motion.
Lori Cannon, no.
Lawrence Tilley, no.
Mark Dekoff, yes.
Steve Miller, yes.
Linda Goosens, no.
Barbara Howard, yes.
So it didn't pass.
However, can we discuss the possibility of doing something?
You can do another motion.
You can just do another motion.
Okay. I like to make a motion that we
You want me to make it?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I make a motion that we take out the admin of $18,719 out of that, leaving the support staff for $28,044.
Second.
Take the vote. Mark Decoff, yes.
Steve Miller, yes.
Barbara Howard, yes.
The Goosens, no.
Lawrence Tilly, no.
Lauren Kahn, no.
Okay, nothing's going to pass here. Hey.
I make a motion to reduce the line by $10,000.
Second.
I'd like to amend the motion to reduce the admin by $10,000.
Second.
The admin?
Yeah. Because it's split.
What are you doing?
Reduce the admin line by $10,000.
The admin. So you're going to reduce $46,763 to $36,000.
Who does the admin cover?
Yeah.
11 people. It covers principal, assistant principal,
director of instruction, special ed director, buildings and grounds director, me.
Two and a half guidance.
Yep, guidance.
Deb, yep. Kathy.
At the kneecap scores up.
Anyone?
I understand some of the personal on it, but when you
nurse.
Look at cost of living increases, fuel increases, food increases, insurance increases, there should not be personal when you're, dealing with somebody's economic status.
Have you seen the salaries of the administration that we just went down the list for? With guaranteed step and track movement, no matter what the economy is, guaranteed retirement, regardless.